in my lifetime, and when we were younger, I mean, we would draw and drink water directly. No water bottles were available, nothing was available, nobody carried water. And every possible stream was potable water. We could drink straight from the streams. Today, yeah, we can drink, but there is no water. Everybody has started exploiting it. There is so little water now. I don't think so this can go on for another 5 or 10 years. I think this has all happened in the last 15, 20 years. So we started noticing all this. There was tremendous amount of poaching, extremely high number of smuggling incidences. So I think there were communities which depended on only smuggling timber and making a living. There was a few who were interested in this extraction business. They had set fires to many areas. It was very systematically done, involving people and, you know, the lobbies, you know, who all only saw money. I think that was really sad, you know. You would also look at yourself like a fool, you know. You said, it's not yours, you know, why are you trying to protect it? If you cut a tree, it will not come and complain, it will not file a case, you know, it just gets cut. So you have to be the voice of those things. As a citizen, if you are not interested in, you know, in your environment, I mean, nobody will be interested. When the entire community goes against forest department saying they have done something wrong, we are the only people who are saying, no, you know, what they have done is right. You know, the first time I saw a sloth bear after the villages rehabilitated from Bhadra, I think that meant a lot of meaning for me. Those areas never had sloth bears. It kind of gave you a feeling that, okay, they are back. You know, when people are moving away, animals are coming. Nature wins over people, I'm definitely very sure. So today, if I look at it, I think it's a passing stage. I think there is a lot of hope. It is possible to take a stand. It is possible to protect. It is possible to really defend.